Welcome back to the inquiry into the use of cannabis in Victoria.
Bringing cannabis use out of the shadows and destigmatising it will allow for a far better understanding of its impact on public health and safety and allow us to engage in education and conversations with both young people and with wider society that are honest and trusting and free from discrimination.
Is there any evidence that the education in particular would help for the young people, particularly in the use of cannabis, in comparison to the education about the harmfulness of alcohol?
I believe the evidence shows that although there is still widespread alcohol issues and problematic use of alcohol, in fact, there is a better knowledge amongst people generally across society in our community about what is safe alcohol use, and certainly more opportunities for discussions about that, and certainly more sort of factual information about how to reduce your alcohol use and to drink safely. And I would just want to mirror that in cannabis, while in all the illicit drugs, actually, while recognizing that there really is no silver bullet that will stop all harm related to drug use and alcohol use.
We've seen in lots of other jurisdictions, they've looked at the age at the minimum age. And in some jurisdictions, we're seeing it at 18, in some we're seeing it at 21. We saw recently in the New Zealand proposal that they would restrict it to a minimum age of 20. Does SSDPA have any position on where we should draw that line?
Although there are developmental harms when consuming cannabis from, let's say, the ages of 18 to 21, are the odds that keeping the age at 21 is going to stop those 18 to 21 year old, technically adults, from consuming cannabis? Or is it better to give them a legalized model that has, for example, public health interventions embedded in it? So I think that those are the interesting questions.
Yeah. Can you expand on the role you see for school-based education programs and primary prevention programs beyond broader, you know, mass market sort of public health campaigns?
High school drug education, I think, needs a complete overhaul. It's misinforming. It's like don't do drugs, and it's also stigmatizing, which then means that young people are going to be less likely to feel comfortable talking to their friends, the teachers, their family about what they're actually doing.
Young people actually interact with it. How they actually use this drug education is they need to be able to interact with it. They need to be able to share it. They need to be able to use it on multiple platforms. It needs to be a combination of videos. It needs to be using things like memes. It needs to be able to create and start conversation where young people can share stories and creates the beginning of a conversation rather than just a lecture format that they may have been receiving in the past.
Is there evidence or otherwise on the impact of cannabis use as a contributing factor to violence and the impact on persons' mental health?
This is something where it's really important to tailor harm reduction education so people are really conscious of their individual risk profile. Be aware whether they're predisposed to a condition, say schizophrenia, because there is some evidence that cannabis can exacerbate mental health conditions if someone is already predisposed.
We're not economists and we're not clinicians, but we are people with a lived experience of illicit drug use. And we've got an experience of being told that we have a health issue while being treated as a criminal. And we know for a fact that this mixed messaging is counterproductive, and it leads to us avoiding reaching out to talk about and act on issues related to drug use as a result. I personally think that we owe the next generation a way better way forward than this.